everybody. Many of you have appreciated my video about the Morton's neuroma and how to recover from it. So today I'm going to talk about my fight back from stress fracture. Now, don't ask me about any other injury. Hopefully I won't have any. So I wanted just to share this experience that I went through, and hopefully this will turn out to be useful for you. What I will focus on is three things. One is prevention, and you realize that you have done things that you shouldn't have done. And so that's part one. Part two is a diagnosis. And part three, obviously the most important, is recovery. Once you find out that you have it, what do you do to get back 100%? Now, obviously, I'm not a doctor. I'm just sharing my experience. I think it's important to understand that the objective of the recovery is what drives really how the recovery is performed. So my objective was to run a marathon, and guess which one? 2 weeks after the marathon, to run an ultra, the Miwok 100K. So that's how I structured my plan. I think looking back, there are some learnings that I can share with you. Let's start with number one, with prevention. You may think, why me? Well, you know, I think I know why me. I ran the Tahoe Rim Trail 100 on July 18 last year. Less than a month later, I ran Fat Dog 120, and I was feeling unbreakable. And so that's mistake number one. You are not. And although you're not mentally, you're so happy that you went through that and you were successful, on the other hand, your body needs rest. The week after Fat Dog, I did the back for 1.5 hours, and then ran 10 miles on top of it in one run. And then the week after that, I did 40 miles, including speed work and a 21-mile run. So that is probably what caused this stress fracture. And it started with the pain in my left tibia, here. I can still feel it, the bone callus. What I thought at the beginning was, oh, these are shin splints. Tried massaging, creams, nothing worked. Mistake number two is I didn't stop running. I couldn't bear looking at Strava and seeing 0 miles. So I was running once a week, 10 miles. I needed to see that double digit on Strava. So lesson number two, stop running. It's better that you understand what you have and how to solve it, then try to recover and making the situation a whole lot worse. So it was time to see a doctor. The only thing that I knew is that I had pain. At that point, I had figured out it could be stress fracture. And it's really easy to diagnose stress fracture. Looking at the x-ray, you can see that there is a stress fracture. What they told me is no running. Okay, doctor, thank you very much. That much I had figured. It took me some time, but I figured that out. And then he gave me a brace that I really recommend. And probably something that, you know, if you feel pain and you want to protect an area, this would be a great brace to have and to buy. The brace is the Aircast ankle brace. This is padded and it's air. You can actually blow inside to put more pressure or less pressure with the air. And then you put it like this, and then you strap it around. One. And two. And so this really helps. The pain is right here, right? And so it helps you push away the pressure from the bone to the leg. And I think in general, if you have a braces like this or even softer, that may actually help prevent injury. Right now I feel very secure. I can go run with it, and I went on trail running with this. In fact, it shows, because if you look at the stirrup, it's really destroyed. I had to fix it. And by the way, you can use it also without the stirrup. So when the doctor gave me the brace, obviously I thought, well, you know, that's nice of him just to give him this to me. What happened is that this you can actually buy on Amazon, and right now the large measure, which is the most expensive, costs a whopping $30.61. However, I later received a billeton for the deductible, $50.32. And that was just part of what they charged the practice, which was $126.12. Bottom line, I had a diagnosis, I had a great brace, and then I now just needed a recovery plan. So this is a phase recovery plan. Phase one, very easy, no running. For 4 weeks, I felt it was better not to run. However, we built up this endurance over years, and we don't want to lose it by just doing nothing for 4 weeks, right? I went to the gym, and I went like 3 hours a week with my brace on, obviously. I tried to find things that worked out for me. And what worked out for me is called espresso.net. I would be there for an hour and 15, maybe three times a week. So that was phase one. Phase two, I started running again in a five-week progression. The first week, I was running like every other day, 15 to 20 minutes. Week two, I was running 20 to 30 minutes. And then week three, I was running, again, every other day, probably 20, 30, 40 minutes. And week four, I got up to 50 minutes. And week five, I got up to 1 hour. So I was starting maybe 20, 40, 60 minutes. And obviously, I was very careful not to push, right? If I felt that I needed more exercise, what I did, I went back to the gym. The Stairmaster, that was my other favorite exercise. Always with the brace. After 5 weeks of running progressively more, I felt I could go run every day. Most of the time, though, I was doing no more than 1 to 1.5 hours, always using the brace. And by the time I actually started destroying this brace that I had, and I actually started using another brace. This is from DonJoy. It's called ProForm, and it's recommended for there are these two ridges. They don't compress easily, right? If you slip it on, and you put these ridges right in the middle where the pain is, and you close it, when you press down, these ridges, they won't compress, they absorb. And it makes a huge difference. And again, this is recommended also for shin splints. So if you have pain, you don't know what it is, I highly recommend this. This is less than $30. I got it at betterbraces.com. I started my next phase, which was rebuild the base. My concept was this. What really caused the breakage was the long races, well, obviously, those influenced, but it was the speed work that actually created the crack. I want to avoid that. I want to rebuild the base. I wanted to start doing long runs first. As you can see here from this graph, I ran 2 days a week, just Saturday and Sunday. I also introduced spinning, which was really fun, at the gym 2 hours a week. And then a Bikram yoga. My Sunday run was, as you can see here, was pretty long, like 3.5 hours on Sundays, sometimes 4. Long runs, on trails, lot of elevation, muscles are coming back, stress is not a match because you are on trail and you're not pushing and you have the brace. So I was now 2 months before Boston and it was time to all-round training, including speed work. What I did is I followed the official Boston training program and with a target time for me of 3:15. The moment of truth came. I ran Boston. I decided to wear the DonJoy brace because I had 2.5 weeks after I had the Milwaukee 100 to do, and I didn't want to risk it. So I ran it. I did the 3:17, which is same time as last year. Actually, it was 47 seconds slower than last year. So I can say at this point that I'm out. 2 weeks ago, I ran the Milwaukee 100, and now I have no pain. The ordeal, the stress fracture is over. And probably took me 6 to 7 months fully recovered, that I can now increase my training. And so don't despair. Get braces, get on the bike, try something new like Bikram, like spinning, and be patient yet persistent. Don't get yourself down. Keep on doing something. Stick to a plan. What helped me is at the end of the day, seeing that I was progressing and always adding one more piece to the plan. So I now have this five-phase plan that I hope that it will help you. Maybe your plan again will be different, your objective will be different, but you should have one. So good luck, and I'll see you back on the road.